Good morning. Today I am solving the question number 1 of exercise 1.5. Question is saying you classify the following numbers as rational numbers or irrational number. Which type of numbers are these? So 2 minus root 5. You know from previous video 2 is rational number, under root 5 is irrational numbers. Fine. So when you are watching the property rational plus irrational equal to irrational. Understand and remember it. Rational minus irrational will always be irrational. So if rational and irrational subtraction is given, the number will be irrational. Fine. 2 minus root 23 minus root 23. 3 minus root 23 minus root 23. When you will solve it, you will take minus common root 23 plus root 23. This will give you 3 minus 2 root 23. This is rational and this is under root 23 is irrational, and this is 2 is rational. Fine. So remember, irrational into rational is always irrational, means rational into rational, irrational. This is irrational, complete irrational. And from this property, rational. Now rational, this complete become irrational. Then rational minus irrational from this property is a irrational number. So this will also be irrational number. This number is irrational numbers. Fine. Irrational number. Third question. Cancel root 7, root 7. You will get 2 by 7. 2 by 7. You know that it is in form of P upon Q. That's why it is a rational number. Rational number. Rational number. Fine. 1 by root 2. You know the property. 1 is rational and root 2 is irrational. So you know the property rational upon irrational. What? Always gives you rational upon irrational, always gives you irrational number. So this will also be a irrational number. These are the property which I am telling you. I have told in the previous video, go through the previous video, you will understand the concept very deeply. Fine. These are the properties. Pi is irrational and this is rational. Rational into irrational, what? Rational into irrational equal to irrational number. So this is also irrational number. Fine. Thank you. Good morning. Exercise 1.5, question number 2 I am solving today. Simplify each of the following expression. You are given here 3 plus root 3, 2 plus root 2. So simplify means we have to multiply this bracket with this bracket. So 3 into 2 plus root 2, when you will multiply 3 by this bracket. Then plus sign root 3 into this bracket, 2 plus root 2. Now 3 into 2, 6 plus 3 root 2 plus 2 into root 3 plus root 2 into root 3. Fine. This is 6 plus 3 root 2 plus 2 root 3 plus root 2 into root 3, root 6. Fine. This is your answer. Second part is simplify this. This is identity. You just remember here A plus B and A minus B. You know A plus B, A minus B is A square minus B square. Fine. A plus B and A minus B. So you can write here 3 square minus root 3 square. 3 square 9 minus root 3 square 3. That will give you 6. That is your answer. Next part, third part. Root 5 plus root 2 square. Open the formula A plus B whole square. A plus B whole square equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB. Fine. Here A is root 5, B is root 2. So you simplify and then put the value of A square plus B square plus B square plus 2AB. Root 5 square plus root 2 square plus 2 into root 5 into root 2. That means root 5 square 5, root 2 square 2 plus 2 into root 5 into root 2, root 10. Fine. This is your answer. Next, root 5 minus root 2, root 5 plus root 2. This is a minus b and a plus b. A minus b, a plus b, from this identity, we can say a square minus b square. A plus b, a minus b, a square minus b square. So you get here, a is what here? Root 5, b is root 2. A square, root 5 square, b square, root 2 square. This will give you root 5 square 5 minus root 2 square 2. That means 3. 3 is your answer. Thank you. Question number 2 complete. Question number 4 represent under root 9.3 on number line. First of all, we draw the line segment of 9.3. Suppose this is AB. A, B. A to B distance is 9.3 centimeter. Fine. Take one more centimeter from B further. This will give you point C. This is 1 centimeter. Again you take one. You can write here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 like this. Fine. Now you just take AC line segment and do the perpendicular bisector of AC. How do you do the perpendicular bisector? Take more than half distance, taking O as a center, and draw the arc upside and downside both in both directions. Then, to don't change your distance in compass, take C as a center and draw the arc upside and downside both sides. Then join where the arcs are intersecting like this. Fine. This intersecting point take O, and here you will take O as a center and OC as a radius. Take O as a center and OC as a radius and draw a semicircle. Draw a semicircle. Like this. Fine. Now on B point, you will draw the 90 degree angle by compass or by protractor. You can draw here by compass. How will draw 90? Take this arc. Then put compass here. Take arc, this here. And then put compass here and cut it here. Then join the arc fine. This is your 90 degree angle and you have to take only by this point where the arc is this line is cutting the semicircle. This distance we do not take here, till here we are taking. Then join, suppose this is the point D. Then join OD. Fine. Now put compass on B, or you can take B as a center and BD radius. BD radius like this. Fine. We are taking B as a center and draw the arc like this. Draw the arc like this. Fine. So the arc will come here like. Fine. So this point will you represent under root 9.3. Fine. This point will represent under root 9.3. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and between 3 and 4, you will get the value under root 9.3. This is your answer. Thank you. Good morning. Question number third, exercise 1.5 is saying you recall pi is defined as a ratio of circumference of the circle to its diameter, say d, that is pi equal to c upon d, means pi equal to circumference upon diameter. This seems to contradict the fact that pi is irrational number. How would you resolve this contradiction? Here, what is the contradiction? You know, pi is irrational number. C upon D is in form of fraction, or we can say C upon D is in form of P upon Q. That's why it is a rational number by the definition of rational number. So how this irrational equal to rational? This is the contradiction given here. And this contradiction you have to resolve. For resolving the contradiction, we will show that irrational equal to irrational. In which condition or in which case we will show that irrational equal to irrational. Fine. So this contradiction irrational equal to rational, we have to first resolve in the question. Given pi equal to c upon d, you know this is rational number, c upon d is rational number. Here c and d both will also be rational number. By the definition of rational number, we can say c and d individually will also be rational numbers. Fine. Pi irrational number, and definition of irrational number says that it will have non-terminating, non-repeating decimal expansion. This is c upon d fractional form, rational number, and this its decimal expansion comes either terminating or non-terminating repeating. So by the definition of irrational number, we are getting this result. By definition of irrational number, we are getting this result. Both the results are different, means this is the contradiction. There is a contradiction. Result should be same. So now you understand. You know the property, when you divide irrational by rational number, you get irrational number. When you divide rational by rational, you get irrational number. When you divide irrational by rational, then you get irrational number. So can we say that from equation 1, this is equation 1, from equation 1, can we say that if C and D both are irrational number, C and D both are irrational, if C and D both are irrational, then we will get this number as a irrational number, and then this irrational will be equal to irrational, contradiction will resolve. Or if you can say that if we have taken this condition both, now you see, if either of C or D is irrational, take here, if C is irrational and this is rational, then what you get? If C is rational, this is irrational. What do you get? Irrational number. Then also this will become irrational number. Then also irrational will be equal to irrational. Contradiction will resolve by this condition also. If you take third condition, C as irrational number and D as rational number, then also irrational upon rational, irrational number. This will become your irrational number, and irrational will be equal to irrational number. Then also contradiction will resolve. So you have to write this condition, this property and this condition in your answer along with this. Fine. Contradiction will resolve. So we use this property and this language for giving the answer. Thank you. In other books also given different approximate value. You can go through that answer also, but you have to understand that very clearly. Fine. Thank you. Good morning. Today I am teaching you rationalization. Many questions an exam will be covered from this chapter, so read it very clearly. Question basically ask you rationalize the denominator in the given question. So rationalizing the denominator means we will make the denominator in the given question as a rational number, means convert a denominator, whatever it may be, as a rational number. Generally it is given you irrational number, you have to convert irrational number to a rational number. Or you can say that denominator should be without square root. That is in your syllabus. Fine. Now question is, one more thing you understand here. What is the conjugate term? Conjugate. Fine. Suppose you are given binomial x plus y. The conjugate of x plus y will be x minus y. This is the conjugate. Fine. You are given the polynomial root 3 minus root 2. Then its conjugate will be root 3 plus root 2. How do you get the conjugate? Just change the sign between these two terms. You will get the conjugate of that binomial. Fine. Or any polynomial. So now here you see, here we are not having the denominator. Here question is asking you rationalize the denominator of this number. So under root 3 we have to rationalize. Rationalize means we have to made under root 3 a rational number. Fine. So here this denominator is not in this form. Fine. So in this question we will make it, we will multiply this number by root 3 in numerator and denominator both. Why we multiplied by root 3? So that this multiply will cancel root. Multiply of root 3 will cancel root. So solve it. 2 into root 3, 2 root 3 upon root 3 into root 3, 3. This is your answer. This is, we have rationalized. Next, question number 2. 1 by 3 plus root 2. Conjugate of 3 plus root 2. From here, what? Change the sign plus as a minus. So this is 3 minus root 2. By the conjugate, you multiply numerator and denominator both. Root 3, 3 minus root 2. Fine. 1 into this, 3 minus root 2. This is a plus b, a minus b. A square minus b square. This will give you 3 minus root 2 upon 9 minus 2. That will give you 3 minus root 2 upon what? 7. Root 2 square 2. Now, third question, rationalize it. Rationalize the denominator of this question. So, conjugate of this number is 7 minus, change the sign, 7 minus 3 root 2. Both the terms will remain same, only sign will be changed. Fine. 7 minus 3 root 2. Whatever the conjugate is coming, we will multiply its numerator and denominator both by that conjugate. Like this. So, solve it. It will give you 1 into this, 7 minus 3 root 2 upon a plus b, a minus b, a square minus b square. This will give you 7 minus 3 root 2 upon 7 square 49 minus 3 square 9 into 2 root 2 square 2. That will be 7 minus 3 root 2 upon 49 minus 18. 49 minus 18 will give you 31. What? 31. Fine. Next question. 4 minus root 5 upon 4 plus root 5. Rationalize it. You have to rationalize it. Then what is the conjugate of denominator here? That is 4 plus 4 minus root 5. Its conjugate is 4 minus root 5. So by conjugate you will multiply in the numerator and denominator both. 4 minus root 5. This is a minus b, a minus b. So a minus b, a minus b can be written like a minus b whole square. 4 minus root 5 whole square. And this is a plus b, a minus b. A square minus b square. Fine. Open the formula. A square minus a minus b whole square. A square 4 square. 4 square plus root 5 square minus 2 into 4 into root 5 upon 16 minus 5. 4 square 16 plus 5 minus 2 4 is 8 root 5 upon 11. Fine. 16 plus 5. 21 minus 8 root 5 upon 11. This is your answer. Why this is answer? Because we have got the denominator as a rational number. Fine. Thank you.